Hey YouTube. John Williams has had his film scores compared to a lot of classical music, and I'm sure he's not alone. I'm sure there are other composers of scores for anything, movies, games, whatever, that sound similar to classical pieces. And you see a similar comparison in the pop music era and rock and all that stuff. This song copied that song. Who was first? Is it illegal? You plagiarized. You stole my song. And sometimes pop music even takes straight-up sequences from classical pieces, like Memories by Maroon 5 is just Pachelbel's Canon in D. Now, I like something that Charles Cornell said in one of his videos, which was about comparing Star Wars and other themes of John Williams' classical music, and he said that John Williams was probably paying homage to his inspiration, and that was in reference to The Planets by Gustav Holst, which I agree with that. I think that's very possible. But also, it was a two-set violin video that got me started on this topic. And in that video, or top comment on there, it was mentioned by somebody that a lot of times they'll put classical music on top of a film for test purposes, and then the director ends up falling in love with that piece and asks their composer to write something near identical. You know, I've had that happen a few times. Me looking online, finding Creative Commons music for things. Not that I've written something near identical, but I have fallen in love with certain pieces, and I found it hard with the idea of doing something else. There's some music that is Creative Commons, but if you want to use it commercially, you have to contact the person first, but they never responded to any messages on SoundCloud. I don't think they're around anymore, and the music is really too short for my film that I'll be filming in a year or two. And so, it's like, I love that. I'm attached to it, but I'm gonna have to let it go. And I'll get some custom music for my film. I think that'll be a little nicer. And, you know, I'm looking forward to seeing what people come up with for my projects for custom music. And I'll point this out a little bit later on. But, you know, listening to pieces that are available to you or other songs, they can inspire inspiration. And sometimes you'll come up with an idea for something that you might not have thought about in your film, your piece. Oh, this song that I like has a swell at this point. Oh, I could add this one intense thing to my story, and a lot of cool things. So, first example, this is one that people have already compared to before, and then we'll have my example, which I found because I was listening to the song that this is very similar to, and I found another section that's similar to a different Star Wars song. So this is John Williams' Tatooine theme. I want to play Star Wars Droidworks now. And here is a section from the Rite of Spring, section 9, the introduction. A little slower, but identical chords. Even the swells from the other instruments. There's where that song starts going off somewhere else, but now listen to the swells that we get in just a moment here. This is where the two songs go off in different places. Also, 33 dislikes? Why? I mean, this is such an underrated theme, perfectly captures the isolation and the mystery of the planet. But now, here's the comparison that I found while I was scrubbing through the Rite of Spring to hear that section right there. So here's the Star Wars song from on the Death Star. And the Rite of Spring section. Why is it? And it has this again. And then here's where this piece goes off into something completely different. But it has this tense part, and then it goes quiet a bit, kind of like Star Wars. This is a comparison that I've not seen made by other people, but I think is very similar, and I do think it's kind of cool that I noticed it, but even then, again, I don't think that John Williams was completely plagiarizing and stealing from any of the original songs. He was maybe making copies. I'm sure they probably paid the right royalties and licenses for this stuff. But also, you know, I talked about listening to a piece and being inspired by things and ideas coming. Where this piece goes right here, it sounds to me like you have, I don't know, a dragon or a demon that's risen up from hell and is setting a medieval village on fire and burning everything. Listening to the pieces can be very inspiring. So anyways, if you guys liked this video, obviously leave a like down below. Especially if this was a new comparison of John Williams to classical pieces that you hadn't heard before. If you're thinking about subscribing, go check out my other stuff. This is kind of a one-off thing. I don't usually do stuff like this. But also share this video with your friends and family if you did enjoy it and it was something new. And I'll see you guys in whatever's next. Bye.